The way students are educated this school year will look different for districts across the country. COVID-19 has provided a unique set of challenges for returning to traditional education. I'm Cami Weinkoff. DC Ever school district leaders are preparing to reopen schools and get your child back in the classroom. They've developed new protocols and procedures for every school with the safety and well-being of students, their teachers, and staff at the heart of every decision. These standards are based on guidelines set by local, state, and national health leaders. In this video, we'll walk you through those protocols and show you what in-person instruction could look like. Most importantly, if anyone in your family is showing signs of COVID-19, your children should stay home from school. Those symptoms include, but are not limited to, a fever of 100 degrees or higher, a runny nose, cough, or shortness of breath. Parents should check for these symptoms daily before sending their child in. If a student does show signs of illness, they will be isolated and are required to be picked up from school immediately. Staff members and teachers will be wearing face coverings. Under state mandate, students 5 years old and up are required to mask as well through the end of September. There are additional hand sanitation stations throughout each building. Increased cleaning of heavily used areas like bathrooms and plexiglass barriers are being added in public areas where physical distancing isn't possible. These clear dividers will help maintain physical distancing in the classroom, and weather permitting, tents will allow students to take class outdoors. Around school buildings, these floor stickers will help mark travel and highly used areas. To reduce the number of people inside the building and eliminate large gatherings, assemblies have been canceled this year, and there will be staggered use of shared spaces. Students will follow drop-off and pickup protocols established at their specific schools. No visitors or volunteers will be allowed in. Inside the cafeteria, stickers will mark seating. All food served at school will be wrapped or pre-served by staff, and shared serving utensils will no longer be used. Menus will be online, and students will use a touchless checkout system. In-person instruction will look different at grade level. 4K students will attend in-person half-day classes 5 days a week. Elementary school students, kindergarten through fifth grade, will also attend 5 days a week, Monday through Friday, but it'll look a little different than in years past. Class sizes may be smaller, and students will be placed in cohorts and only intermingle with other students within their assigned group in their assigned area of the building. Safety measures will be in place to avoid cohorts crossing paths in a hallway, at lunch, or recess. As for middle and junior high school students, they'll use a blended instruction model. Students will be divided into two cohorts. Cohort A will attend school in person Monday, Wednesday, and every other Friday. Cohort B will attend school in person Tuesday, Thursday, and every other Friday. When not in person, students will take part in remote learning. At the senior high level, district leaders have come up with a plan that will allow students a unique, flexible, in-person schedule based on the courses they're enrolled in. Like the middle and junior high schools, students will be divided into cohorts, assigned Monday and Wednesday, or Tuesday and Thursday. Some courses, like Tech Ed, will meet daily as the large spaces allow for physical distancing and it's hard to engage in hands-on learning virtually. Fridays will allow students the chance to sign up for specific classes where extra help is needed, or they can take part in enrichment activities. Teachers will also offer these opportunities for meeting virtually. For those students without a means of transportation, district leaders will work to offer them accommodations. Campus will also be open with designated learning areas where students can stay for a study hall or until they can be picked up. Physical distancing protocols will be in place. Think of it more like a college campus. Students will engage in remote schoolwork when possible and will use time in class for hands-on learning like lab work, tech ed courses, or collaborative projects. High school staff are more than willing to work with individual families and students to make this plan work for everyone. Be on the lookout for more details regarding these instructional models in the coming weeks. Those updates will come from your student's school principal. You can also find them on the Future Ready Restart page.